Blackstone Publishing presents Light of Impossible Stars, an Embers of War novel by Gareth L. Powell. This book is read by Nicol Zanzarella, Amy Landon, Joe Hempel, Natasha Soudek, Soneela Nankani, Andrew Eiden, and Emily Lawrence. For Kath and Alexander. O gentle child, beautiful as thou wert, why didst thou leave the trodden paths of men too soon, and with weak hands, though mighty heart, dare the unpastured dragon in his den? Percy Bysshe Shelley, Adonais.
Prologue 1. Trouble Dog. So, I asked, what's the object of this game? The Edelwolf smiled. To win. We were sitting in a virtual environment, a recreation of the Palace of Versailles. Beyond the high windows, ornate gardens stretched away. Fountains sparkled in the clean white sunlight. Edelwolf had dressed his avatar in a dark silk robe. His bony wrists protruded from its sleeves. I had contented myself with my default option, a shaggy-haired, androgynous-looking woman in a battered trench coat. A marble chessboard sat on the table between us. And how do you do that? You capture your opponent's king. That's this tall one? Yes. That's it? In essence, yes. And what about these horsey ones? The Edelwolf gave a tight smile. The knights. Yes, I like those. I leaned over the board and tapped one of the pieces in my first rank. And these are the prawns? Pawns. And these cock-shaped ones? Bishops. Got it. Are you ready to play? I think so. Who goes first? I do. Edelwolf reached out a thin arm and plucked a knight from the back row. He moved it over the pawns and placed it on its destined square. I frowned in puzzlement. Edelwolf sighed. What's the matter? That's it? That's your move? It's a classic opening gambit. It doesn't seem to have achieved much. I suppose you can do better? Of course. I leaned back in my chair and cracked my knuckles over my head. I braced my feet against the tiled floor and grinned. Watch this. I sprang forward. The fingers of my right hand jabbed Edelwolf in the throat. He started to fall backwards, and I flipped the table with my left. By the time the last marble pieces rattled down onto the floor, I was kneeling on his chest with his king held triumphantly in my hand. I win, I said. Edelwolf coughed, massaging his battered larynx. You really don't understand chess, do you? I sniffed and clambered to my feet. On the contrary. I let the marble king fall from my fingers. It bounced off his ribs with a hollow thump and rolled away across the floor. You just don't understand tactics.
Prologue 2. Sal Constance. How about now? Still a blur, I'm afraid. On the screen, the Trouble Dog's avatar frowned. She pursed her lips. Wait. Are you getting something? Yes, she said. I think it's starting to resolve. But all I can see are stars. That's all I can see on the screens. We were parked in empty space. 3 light years from the nearest star system. The Trouble Dog's sister ship, the Edelwolf, hung a few dozen kilometers off our starboard flank. No ultraviolet, no infrared? Sorry, I shrugged. Just the boring old visible spectrum, I'm afraid. How do you people do it? Do what? Find anything. The avatar threw up her hands. This is like being half blind. I touched the wad of bandage covering the empty socket that had until recently housed my right eye. Don't talk to me about being half blind. She looked embarrassed. I apologize, Captain. That was insensitive. I really do appreciate your sacrifice. It's just taking me a little time to get used to seeing with a real, organic eye. I've never used one before. Make the most of it, I said, because it's the only one you'll be getting from me.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.